So in this section we will see the inference on the graphical model. So actually generally what we are considering, that we are considering the problem of computing, means we are trying to estimate the margin, and what we are trying to estimate the margin of, that is the probability density which factorizes according to the graphical model we are having. Means we are having the node potentials and edge potentials, and we don't know they are proportional and what the distribution function they are having, and we are trying to compute or estimate the marginal of probability of density of that. That is the problem which we are considering. So when we are considering such problems, we have to review the sum of the standard graphs and the corresponding usual inference problems, which all amount to compute or approximate the marginal distribution. So starting with the sum standard graph, that is the first one is hidden Markov model. So the hidden Markov model is generally using for factorization of the densities. So suppose we are having the YY nodes. So generally the YY nodes are shaded nodes. So that, why the shading is there? Because that indicates that they are observed. The arrows gives us the idea of progression through time. We can see in the particular graph that all the nodes are connected to each other by the directed edges. So these directions or the arrows gives us the idea of progression through time. Means how the information is carried out, that is known through these directions. So the main arrows are responsible for knowing us the routine, which is telling us how the progression is going on. The main necessary thing is that the graph should invoke the directed acyclic graph. Now this model is also known as hidden or latent variable model. So why so? Because the random variables are not observed, and one is interested in performing the inference about them using the observations of dependent random variables. Means we are not knowing the random variables because they are not observed, but the interest is in performing the inference about them. And how we are performing the inference? By the observations of the dependent variables. That's why they are also called as the hidden or latent model. So now the question will come, where we are using these models in real time? So in real time, we are using such models in the signal processing, where we are trying to track the algorithm in the sequential process, like in bioinformatics, weather forecasting. There we are using this hidden Markov model. Then the next type of graph, which is the part of inference on graphical model, is the star graph. So as the graph representation is in terms of star, it is called as the star graph. So it generally contains the nodes. So the parent node here is the node that is represented as master node 0, and the yi, yk, yj are nothing but the nodes that are carried out from the parent node. So as these are the basic conditions, in this framework we work with some prior mu 0 on the parameters of interest, because 0 is your root node, and that's why we are working on the prior mu 0 on the parameters of interest. Then the model with corresponding likelihood p yk by 0 of batch of data given the parameters, and we are then interested in computing the posterior value. Means we know that 0 is the particular parent node and we are having the interest on mu 0. Then when we are having such type of basic information, the model with the likelihood, that is p of yk by 0 of batch where we are having the data of parameters, and what we are trying to compute from that data, we are trying to compute the posterior value from that data, that what will be our next nodes, that can be calculated by this likelihood, and then the graph is built. So that is the star graph. Then the Ising model is there, which is also the part of inference, that is The icing model is an archetypal example of MRF coming from statistical physics because it is generally used in statistical physics. So the graph is simply a grid with each node being connected with its four neighbors. So we can see in this graph, the nodes are connected with each other. That means they are connected with the four neighbors. We can see over here. They are connected with the four neighbors. Each node is connected to its neighbor, and the edge can represent some notion of similarity. So this particular graph is called as grid because the nodes are connected to neighbors, and that's why the representation is in the form of grid. Each node is connected to its neighbors. The edge can represent some notion of similarity. Now, as each and every node is responsible for connecting to the neighbors of them, that's why they are having some similarity in between them. That's why the edges are possessing the similarity in between them. So that is the icing model. Then comes the inference on graph. So the popular algorithms for inference on graph is the Bilic propagation algorithm, which is also called as BP. So when we are talking about the particular inference, we have to consider the categories, that is tree and graph. So generally, when we are considering this inference, we are using the Bilic propagation algorithm. So for that, generally three set of equations are used. The first one is for pre-messages, the second one is messages, and the third one are nothing but the beliefs. These beliefs are nothing but the quantities which are proportional to the marginals. So for the tree graph, set of equations will lead to the quantities which are called as the beliefs, who are proportional to the marginal. So to compute the marginal, general approximations resort are NBP, that is the non-parametric Bilic propagation, where one propagates the mixture of Gaussian across the graph. That's why it is called as non-parametric BP. Then SOSMP, that is the stochastic message passing, where one represents the messages as some combination of the orthogonal functions. And the third one is PBP, that is nothing but particle BP, where one propagates the set of particles across the graph and the corresponding equations are computed in the variant format. So this is all about the inference on graphs. In our next section, we will see the next topic, that is PGM, which is probabilistic graphical model. Thank you.